Hello, my name is Trevor, and I'm one of the admissions counselors here with the Ayurvedic Institute, specifically supporting with the part-time program. So both our online or our full-time and part-time program are following the same curriculum and same schedule. It's just with the part-time program, you're really taking the courses over the course of 2 years. So with the health counseling program, it is just over 800 hours, and over with the part-time program, you'd be taking it over the course of 2 years rather than 1 year. And with our part-time program, or our full-time program, is 10 months in length, running from September through early June, where in the part-time program, you would start kind of September through early June, and then you'd start the second year in September when the next cohort would start as well. So you would have an additional summer off. And with our school being recognized by NAMA and our program specifically being recognized by NAMA, you do need to be in person. And our expectations for our students are to be in person for 7 weeks. And it might look different with the part-time program, but I always advocate for starting in person for the first couple weeks. And then the rest of the allocated time for in-person could actually be built more towards the second year as we're gearing up towards the clinical component. So I'm going to get my screen sharing here and we can walk through our schedule. So this is our full-time schedule. Where the part-times for the part-time program, you're actually just taking the classes over the course of 2 years, rather than one. All of our classes are live, so there is no recording of the classes for access at a later point. So you do need to be showing up and attending the classes when they are live. And specifically for the part-time program, the foundations of Ayurveda class, as well as the becoming a clinician class, are classes built specifically for the second year, as it's really bringing all of the classes and the content together, as well as gearing you up for the clinical component with this becoming a clinician class and clinic observation as well. So those two classes would specifically be built for the second year within the program. But the remaining of the classes would be flexible in terms of if you would like to take them in the first or second year. But the one thing to note is that all the classes in trimester two and trimester three are a continuation of the previous classes. So if we look at like an Arya Yoga class, let's say you're not able to do this Arya Yoga class during trimester one, year one. So then all three of the Arya Yoga classes, one for each trimester, would actually all be moved to the second year as they add on to each other and they're building off of what we learned in the previous trimester's content. In terms of circling back to that in-person component, for our school year, it starts, classes start full swing September 16th, but orientation would actually be starting the week before. So September 9th would be the kind of the start date of orientation, and we'd be running Monday through Friday, kind of all day, 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Eastern time. And then classes would start full swing the next week. And I would always advocate for coming in person right off the bat so that you're getting familiar with your faculty members, the campus, as well as your classmates. And then with foundations of Ayurveda and becoming a clinician being two classes specifically built for the second year, we could actually really build the second two times to come in person during the second year. So kind of the first 2 weeks of the session one of trimester two of the second year, and then some point during trimester three. But these specific dates will all be dependent on when NAMA has their annual conference, as we want our students to be able to attend that, so we won't have clinic that week. So we want to allow students to be able to partake in that without missing the clinical component. So we wouldn't have you coming in person during that time or even seeing clients online during that time either. So let's just circle back to kind of the start of the school year. So the first session is 2 weeks in length, and that would be a great time to come in person to get to start getting those 7 weeks in person. By all means, you can show up more than that 7 weeks, but that is the minimum requirement for our students. And it would be a great time to just kind of dive fully in if possible. If it works in your schedule, just coming in person and taking all three of these classes would be a great starting point, but no worries if that is not the case. And then the next few sessions over the course of wrapping up trimester one and going into trimester two, they're all 5 week sessions. So you wouldn't actually have class the week ending in November 1st, the week ending in December 13th, the week ending February 14th, or the week ending in March 21st. But I would not go on vacation or anything necessarily at that time, as you will have oral exams, different projects, and ex other maybe written exams or exams on our student portal as well. But just for your awareness in terms of having a little bit more downtime in built kind of in the program. And then a few other things to note is that we would have a week off for the week of Thanksgiving, and then there's around a month between trimester one and trimester two, and then a week off between trimester two and trimester three. Now, in our trimester one and trimester two, most of the sessions are built into 5 weeks. So, in that fifth week or 10th week, if you are adding the two sessions together, there would not be classes, but you would have any exams, or that would be time allocated for any exams. Where the third trimester, we've more built the exams into the first two trimesters, and you'll kind of wrap up the whole program with an oral exam after the completion of all of your courses. So session one and session two in trimester three will be 4 weeks in length, and we'll just run straight through of the classes. And then sometime over the 2 to 3 weeks following this last day of class, May 23rd, would be a 30-minute allocated time slot for an oral exam in that second year, specifically to wrap up the whole program, where it would be covering any of the content from day one through the clinical component, wrapping up the program. So with the first year program, or with the first year of the part-time program, classes would end then May 23rd, and then you would not have class then until around mid-September, once the next school year has started. I can briefly touch on the classes. You can find a more detailed description within the catalog of the courses, but Arya Yoga is going to be the physical practice of yoga from an Ayurvedic lens. Vihara is lifestyle, or I like to also consider like kind of like daily routine. Yogic philosophy. Ahara Chikitsa is going to be food as medicine. So it's going to be focusing on different vegetables, fruits, sweeteners, grains, things of that nature, and what the qualities of those things are, as well as what their taste is and their functions, as well as going into kitchen herbs. Anatomy and physiology, foundations of Ayurveda, again, a second year class within the part-time program that will kind of bring all of the cl classes and content together. Sanskrit class, which is the language that Ayurveda has traditionally been passed on through. Becoming a Clinician class, which is a class that starts off as learning the flow of a consultation, what you're intaking through observing the client versus what you're hearing from the client versus what's their diet, what's their sleep like. And then that class is starting to then transition into actually leading consultations, maybe with your friends or family member for homework assignments, or practicing doing the education component where you're teaching a classmate or a family or friend, or even writing out what kind of education you would give a specific client based off of their concerns. And kind of with this class, there's also the Becoming a Clinician clinic observation. We have the privilege of watching the ASP2, the second year students, doing their consultations and really starting to even see what kind of the end product of the health counseling program is and what you're capable of after completing the first program. And then practically all of these classes do continue into the second and third year. Or to the second and third trimester. And then in terms of tuition, the ASP1 part-time program is $16,700 plus your initial application fee of $150. So within the part-time program, you're actually paying by session. So whatever classes you take in session one, you pay for by this date of September 16th. Whatever classes you're going to start in session two would be due September 30th, and so forth. And I'm going to switch over to this other sheet so we can see the actual breakdown of those costs going into this 24-25 school year. Once you've been accepted into the program, then we'd actually sit down and get you signed up for all of your classes for trimester one, and kind of make a projection for the rest of the trimesters as well as the entirety of the program. But we'd walk through, and you'd have access to the live document that we're working through together to determine what classes you're taking, but then also seeing what exactly the price is going to be for each of the sessions. So if you're as you're looking here, you can see that classes like Foundations of Ayurveda and Sanskrit class, they are starting in session two, but they're running into session three. So they're actually you're paying for the entirety of the course before that class is starting. So these are the prices here for the trimester one classes. You need to pause here. Otherwise, we'll keep moving on to our second and third trimester classes as well. And that is a great overview of our part-time program. Definitely reach out to me if you do have any questions on our part-time program or would like to sit and chat. We should be adding a booking link for my availability here through the summer, as our applications will be due August 15th. I hope to hear from you soon.